Last time, we met Fanutha, Abe, Fikra and Con, the sons and daughter of the great King Lir. Their widowed father remarried. Aoife, the children's new stepmother, grew jealous of the children and transformed them into four white swans and cursed them to roam far from their father and their homeland. They find themselves in Fairyland and searched for a way to reverse the curse and to get home, only to have Aoife's spell destroy the town and whisk the swans away. We join them now as they continue their quest to find their way home and to seek the power to become human once more.
We awoke in the net of the little giant, Finn McCool. He was searching for the salmon of knowledge, a magical fish that was said to possess all knowledge of past, present, and future. But he had caught us instead. We needed to get back to our father. But how? We needed to find a way home. Finn McCool freed us from his net. We asked him for help. But just like the fairies, he wasn't much help either, to be honest.
Compare, so we'll catch a man, I'll cook him, army master, I'll go spare. I found a lot of fishies and the seas are running low, but with luck and line and cunning there is nowhere he can go. The fate is right, the reel is out, no need to act all coy. Just hook the line, come out there blind and help this wee big boy. Rap-di-di-di-da-di-di-di-do, and rump-a-di-di-da-di-di-di-da-di-di-do, and rump-di-di-di-da-di-di-di-da-di-di-di-da. Fishy I do, fishy I don't, fishy I I have gone fishing down the Lagan, cast me line out the buoy, been trawling coast to coast, and now I'm on the Straits of Moyle. The knowledge it would teach would be a prize for any man, so help me out, just shoot a trout and get on me frying pan. I know that I's a trout, but it's a salmon that I need, for with this little sprat, me master will teach me to write and read. So now in my wee causeway, I send up a little prayer to all the gods of Ireland. Oh my God! The fishy's there!
Excuse me. Hello. Sorry.
The salmon of knowledge had been watching Finn McCool's song and dance from the water. He had lost count of how many times he had seen this before.
Yes, well, actually, I've heard of you.
He saw us and came on land to try and offer us some help.
Yes, well, I believe you're the children of Lir. Is that correct? No, listen to me.
But was interrupted by Finn McCool.
Well, I've got some news for you. Yes. I believe you can have the transformation you need. If it, you don't, come on, get me. Come on. Yes. What? Yes. What?
Yes.
Catch me now. Yes, come on. Chase me. Chase me. Blast.
Finn McCool was roasting up the salmon of knowledge for his master. He was under strict instruction not to eat it himself, but the fish fat spat at him. He sucked his thumb to stop the burn, and then the fish escaped.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. I live to fight another
Finn
day.
And Finn McCool gained all knowledge of past, present, and future. He was about to help us, but before we knew it, the wild howling wind came. We were swept up into the air, and darkness fell upon us.
Wild winds will follow where you go. Lay waste to all with a mighty blow. Only one sacrifice from another is made is when the power of this curse will fade.
The wild wind howled and raged. It blew us across the sky, but our wings never failed us. We flew through the heavens and over many lands, never staying in one place for too long, for fear of the wind destroying more of the land.
Call the sea to me, call the sea to set me free, call the sea to me, call the sea. Lost to memory, my life on shore, my friends and family, cause the sea.
We needed rest. In the dead of night we landed, too dark to see where we were. I took Fakra under my left wing, Con under the right. Aoife kept guard in front of me, and there we slept. I dreamt Father was singing to us. We awoke in a gloomy and desolate land. We were confronted by a strange creature. She was a Selkie. She had the power to transform from a seal in the water into a beautiful woman on land. She told us how the sea and the lands had darkened since the great King Lir had lost his children. King Lir grieved deeply and no longer cared for his kingdom. He was too sad to do anything. All he wanted was his children back. Magic was slowly leaving the kingdom and the earth itself was being laid to waste and ruin. The Selkie's once frozen paradise was slowly disappearing, and many of her friends were gone. The Selkie told us of her worry that if he didn't find his children soon, the land and sea would be wrecked beyond repair. We couldn't believe our ears. We needed to get back to our father, now more than ever. But how? We needed to find a way home. We told the Selkie of who we were and what had happened to us. We heard a rumbling in the distance. Aoife's cursed wind had followed us. The Selkie wanted to help us, had to help us, and so she sacrificed the last of her magic for us.
Cease the winds and calm the gales. Change the ending of this tragic tale. With all the powers I possess, use it to clean up Aoife's mess. No longer feathers, beak, or wing. Once again a daughter, and sons of a king.
Only when sacrifice from another is made is where the power of this curse will fade.
The wind calmed. The curse was finally broken, and we were children once more.
We're human again. Thank you,
the Selkie, having given the last of her magic to us, was forever transformed into a seal. She was not sad about this, as she was always happiest when she was out at sea. She asked us to climb on her back, and we glided across the waves at great speed. Back to your land, and back to your father! We arrived on the shore of our homeland. Looking up at the cliff edge, we could see our father, distraught. He had been keeping vigil since the day we vanished. By his side stood Aoife. She was trying in vain to offer him comfort. Aoife's eyes fell on us, and shock and confusion swept over her. She began to panic.
Just look over there.
Overjoyed, our father bounded down from the cliff to the shore. Taking us in his arms, we finally felt safe.
Oh, the children! You're back!
Oh, so good to see you!
I can't believe it!
Yeah, we were.
And then we went
what?
To see Finn McCool.
Swans?
We told him of our ordeal and what Aoife had done. How the lands we had visited were being destroyed by Aoife's curse. Our father was enraged.
They're lying.
All the magic of the elements ignited within him, and with a mighty force, he stripped Aoife of her charms and commanded the very winds she had used to torment us. Now powerless, she was swept up into the air, banished from the lands and out of our lives forever. She was never heard of again. With Aoife gone, and us happily reunited with our father, the land began to heal. The fairies, Finn McCool, and the Selkie all had their homes back. Our father held a great ball to celebrate and invited all the friends we'd met along the way. There once was a great king that lived in Ireland, back when the land was new and full of magic. His name was Lir, and he was god of the sea. We are the children of Lir, and that was our story.
Thank you.